both have really large imaginations, and we believe in like fantasy and our relationship to the natural environment and the urban environment. So we're translating it. The structures are an environment, and the nest is an environment that people can sit in and habitate, but the backgrounds also are the environments for the individual pieces as well, like the pieces live within those. So you start to really look at a home within a home within a home within a home. And I feel like most of our friends and most of us live that way regularly. That's the complex part of our lives.
It's really important in installations also for it to be really interactive and have people be able to like go into things and touch everything, mm-hmm. and like be in a different world that's like not anything like outside or like they're used to seeing any kind of artwork. It's all just like one giant storyline that's continuing, and every room is a different room and a different place. And
yeah, absolutely.
Outside Lands was a project that I got invited to do through Juxtapose's curating the art for that music festival. So it was like kind of a big excuse to hang out and have huge sewing parties and building parties. And like, I think I probably lost money doing it, but I kind of don't care. Like, we made so many beautiful like fabric pieces, and it was super fun and beautiful, and so much beautiful stuff came out of it. And now all the stuff at least me and Bunny have left from it are going to be in the show as much as possible to build out the space. So it's going to be half wood and half fabric, mm-hmm. and then crazy paint.
We do like 48-hour sessions in a row together in the studio where we just sat next to each other and worked. There's not a whole lot of talk about who gets what or who does what. It's more like, do you like how this looks? Do you think this looks funny? And there's just like pieces everywhere to choose from. So you just have to kind of just let go. And it's really easy for both of us to do that with each other when we're working. It seems very comfortable.
This is also the first time we've ever collaborated with each other or worked together in any way. So it just made so much sense. And then it was like, oh, okay, this is the best thing ever. All the material, at least that I use, and I'm pretty sure Benny uses too, is all found or reused or recycled.
Yeah. It's amazing how much has been like accumulated, and all of us are, you know, these urban nomads traveling and coming back and inhabiting different spaces, and the stuff that you collect and the stuff you find like comes with you and then is repurposed and becomes like an explanation for whatever this sort of history that you're building.
You just find so much stuff that people leave behind that's amazing and that nobody wants because it's abandoned and it's trash to a lot of people. The most like tender part of the whole thing is just that every single thing I have and like collect and like the massive hordes of like materials I have are all from a place and like from like an adventure, and I know where every single piece came from or like was gifted from or was picked up from, and then putting them into pieces just makes them very special. And like, this is from my grandmother, and this is from this person that died, and this is the last thing I saw after this building got demolished, and all these little things and every single piece of work that we both make are really important to us, and it just makes it a really personal kind of like a living history, like a timeline of like what we've been going through, and then somehow like that energy gets transferred whether people know that or not, that these are the places we've been, and like it's worn for a reason.